Okay. Hey, everyone. Welcome to Virtual Indoor Cycling. I'm Denise. I'm here at Next Level Athletic Training, and I got a great ride for you. As you jump on your bike and you start to turn your pedals, resistance is low, so it's just easy, I want you to check in for a second with how you feel right now. How do you feel physically? Do you have any aches or pains, soreness, tiredness, tightness? How's your head, your brain, your mind? On a scale of 1 to 10, what's your level of energy? Get up and go. And I want to make you a promise that when we are done, 55 minutes from now, a little less, you are going to feel a whole lot better. You're going to be happier knowing that you've done something to improve your health. Your stress levels will be lower. Your heart will be stronger. And you'll probably even sleep better tonight. So, let's go. Today we're going to look at the idea of power as a measurement, as a way to push yourself and be able to tell how you're working, compared with heart rate or RPE, rate of perceived exertion. So power is literally a number. It's a number on a computer in front of you on your bike. It's wattage. It's how you know in detail how hard you're working. And some of the downsides of working with power is that it's just a little bit complicated. It's a little more complex. Unless you have a really good device in front of you, it's hard to capture. And it can make us too dependent on numbers. The upside is it pushes us harder. Typically, when I've got a number in front of me that I'm reaching for, I usually work a little harder. And so therefore you get results. There's kind of an immediate reward or response. Quick story about that. I was teaching a class yesterday, just an interval step class. And there was a woman in class who the week before had burned 303 calories in our 45 minute class. And so we were watching her on her watch. And I said, you let us know when we're getting close. Well, we got to the last like 3 minutes of class and we had, I think, 40 calories to go. So you better believe that we all turned it up a notch and worked harder than we would have worked because we had a number, we had a threshold to reach for. So when you're working with heart rate, that's a little less complicated, but also less accurate way to know how hard you're working, because heart rate can fluctuate for a lot of reasons. What I like to teach with always, whether you have console or not, is perceived exertion. How hard do you feel like you're working? How does it feel? So right now, it should feel like it's easy, a 6 on a scale of 1 to 10. I'm gonna take it up to 7. So what I'd like you to do is bring your hips to the very back of the saddle. Slow your legs down to match mine. I'm pedaling at about 60 RPMs right now. And I'd like you to find resistance that feels moderate, not too hard, not too easy. And we're gonna settle in right here. We'll be here for about 3 minutes on our way to hard work, okay? Reach your hands forward. Let's stand up and walk it out. So what that should feel like is RPE, rate of perceived exertion, 7. It's like a minute ago, you were sitting on the sofa, watching your favorite Netflix series. And now you're walking around the block. You decided to get up during in between episodes and you're walking. And if you were walking with another person, you could talk just like I am. You're not too winded, but it's effort. You're up and at them, you're getting out. So, do you already feel better? See if you can feel where your tailbone is pointing, because we want the tailbone to point back behind us instead of underneath us here. So in order to get there, we hinge at the hips and we point the tailbone behind us. All right, so that's some stuff about power and perceived exertion. Let's have some fun, huh? Let's burn a few calories, get a little sweat going, be on with our day. So here's what we've got. This class is divided into two stages or two halves. The first part, as you can tell, is a gradual increase in intensity. Up ahead of us, we've got a flat road. We're gonna work our speed drills a little bit. Then there's a steep hill and some breathless intervals. We'll take a break, recover, and then we'll build it again. Strength, endurance, and we'll finish our day with some speed drills. All right, and then so you know, first half is longer and harder than the second half. So it's really not half, I guess. Stage. First stage, second stage. All right. Hopefully your body's a little warmer, yeah? All right. Go ahead and settle your hips. Lower the resistance just a bit. And we're gonna speed up our legs. So let's see what happens if we try to go close to 100 RPMs. It's double time, the beat of the music. And we're gonna stay here for just about 4 minutes. Picture a flat road, nice and gradual out in front of you. But because our legs are turning a little faster, it's a little bit more challenging. Moderate, moving towards hard. This might feel like you are jogging now. Like you just picked up the pace a little bit around your neighborhood. You got an easy little jog going. Let's call this 7.5 on a scale of 1 to 10, all right? So even though we're sitting, the tailbone is still pointing back. There's a pinch or a crease in your hips. Legs moving pretty briskly. Core strong. All right, so just check in, close your eyes. We've been going about 12 minutes. How do you feel? Are those same aches and pains, concerns still present? Has your mood shifted a little bit or your energy level, your thoughts, your brain? Be an observer and just watch as exercise does what it promises. It makes us feel better. It's always hard on the front side. And it always feels great at the end of a ride. Always. So today, we are riding for our own mental health. We're riding to feel better. We're riding for happiness. Let's see if it works. Knees are in line with the feet. Ball of the foot connected to the pedal. That lower body is just doing its thing. Not too hard, not too easy. Shoulders down, smile on your face. And as ridiculous as that sounds, there's this major nerve that runs from the base of your brain down into your gut, and it connects into the face. So when we actually smile, there's a nervous system response that tells our body, calm down. Actually tells our brain, calm down. A simple smile can elicit a different kind of stress response. Try it. Try it on. Plus you look better. You look better when you smile. All there is to it. Notice your breathing. Up ahead, you've got a nice juicy hill. Big hill, the 10-minute hill. We'll do part of it out of the saddle and part of it in the saddle. This is where we hit hard effort, where the sweat will start to pour. Straight up 8 on a scale of 1 to 10. Okay, so there we go. Add resistance until your legs come down to about 65. Point that tailbone back. Get ready to stand. Make sure you've got plenty of resistance right here. Level 8 coming up. Let's get it, come on. All right, so settle in right here for about 4 minutes. Standing climb. Notice your breathing. And see if you can make your breathing more steady, more predictable, more matched with the cadence of your legs. Deep breath in, big breath out. Hands are light. If you do have power, measurement, you just saw those numbers go up. You're pushing harder watts. It's harder effort. If you're wearing a heart rate monitor, you just saw your heart rate go up. And perceived exertion, you can feel in your body that this is hard effort. Probably feels like temperature. Work, sweat, breath. Come on. Keep your feet relaxed. Sometimes we have a tendency to scrunch up our toes in our shoes. See if you can just keep your foot nice and relaxed. Sometimes I just lift my toes, touch the toenails to the top of your shoe. Make sure you're pressing with the ball of the foot. Whew. You got it. Where's that smile? Here we are in the work zone. Hard effort. Core is strong. So good. All right. Woo. Second half of the hill is harder than the first. And you're gonna see why in just a second. Loose hands, soft elbows, deep breath. Woo. Happiness, help, peace, mental health. It's all yours. It's all right here. You got it. All right. Now just start to settle your hips back to the saddle. Keep the resistance on. And just reaccustom yourself to this. Familiarize your work effort. Make it familiar. Adjust. Woo. There we go. There's some leg work right there. Looks good, everybody. Come on. All right. Now hang in there. We're about halfway up this hill. That's the way hills are, man. They're never as short as you think they're gonna be. Grab a sip of water. Take a quick stretch, but stay in the work. Settle in. So when I said the second half is harder than the first, this is what I meant right here. Cadence is just a little bit faster. Push it up a little closer to 70 RPMs. Hard work in the saddle. So now what I want you to be looking for is this magic zone called threshold. If I asked you to stay here for 4 more minutes, how hard would you work? Knowing that that's what you got. 4 minutes, right here at 70 RPMs, hard effort. Are you willing to go right to that line where if you worked any harder, you'd jump above that line? And we don't want to go there yet. I will take you there in the next song. Right now, rush hold. Okay, I told you this is where that sweat starts showing up to the party. Right here, right now. Okay, let's just do some visualization on this hill. Close your eyes. I'm gonna ask you a question. What makes you happy? I want you to notice how much of that is external. How much of that, what makes me happy, is in the periphery of where you are right now. It's like ahead of us. We're trying to get to it. It's over here. And if I could just reach out a little farther, I could get it. Very often when we're asked that question, we think of the word more. More free time. More money in the bank. Bigger house. Faster car. Better health. Nicer friends. People on social media that think like me. I want more in order to be happy. So we know where that goes, right? And we say, I'll be happy when we're never, ever happy. Because we get to that thing, and then there's more. There's bigger. There's someone with a faster car. Someone with better grades. Someone with a better paying job. Or they weigh less on the scale, or whatever. Always more. So I'll introduce a little yoga philosophy, kind of life philosophy, that happiness is not out there, it's right here. And when? Is it right here? Right now. Right now. On this hill, on a bike going nowhere, I can choose to run the circuitry of happiness. I can choose that. I can breathe in and just know that I'm breathing in. I can push these pedals and tell myself that this is something that makes me happy. I know it sounds simple, and I know that there are times when it doesn't work, because things are really dark. But I believe it's a starting place. So how about if we just practice right now on this hill? Practice riding happy. Riding happy. Turn a little more resistance on and pedal faster. Just pedal faster. What just happened is we crossed the line. We went over into that breathless zone, and we can still be happy up here. For 3, 2, 1, drop resistance. Okay. Woo. That was kind of a sermon to get your mind off the road for a minute. And now let's come back. Breathless intervals, and then recovery, and our first stage is over. Okay? All I'm gonna ask of you is 10 seconds of work. That's it. A bunch of times, but I'm gonna ask that we'll never go longer than 10 seconds in this song. We got about 7 minutes. Are you ready? Let's try it. Turn resistance on and pedal as hard as you can for 10 seconds. That's it. Bring it back to easy. Now I'm gonna just kind of surprise you with some of those through these 7 minutes. Some surprise pop-up 10-second drills. So what you have to do is crank that resistance, sit or stand, and pedal faster. Okay? That's all you gotta do for 10 seconds. Let's go right now, 10 seconds. Come on, resistance. Plus speed, sit or stand, your choice. Breathless. Drop it down. Woo. If you want, you can count how many of these we do. I don't really have a plan. It's gonna be surprising you. Random. Woo. So that means you have variable recovery from your 10-second pushes. Ready, go. Come on, 10 seconds. Hard as you can go. Resistance on, legs fast, it's only 10. Drop it down. Easy, easy. All right, happiness. Right here, right now. I'll be happy when this workout is over. Right here, right now. 10 seconds, go. Come on, hard as you can go for 10. Sit or stand, be what you got. And down, breathe, recover. Woo. 5 minutes to go. You don't know how many to expect. I think we've done four. Four 10-second sprints. Feels good, huh? Feels good to feel good. Ready, go! And down. 10 seconds. Ain't no thing. Woo. Oh, yeah. Breathe. Breathe. Ready, go. Give me 10. Come on. Surprise 10. That's all you gotta do. Crank it for 10. You can do anything for 10 seconds. Back off. Woo. Just counting. Was that 6? I don't know. Take a deep breath in through your nose, out through your mouth, and just put that smile on your face. It might feel fake, that's okay. Put it on your face, see what happens. Ready, go, 10, come on. Down, woo, ah. If you're a teacher, an instructor, this is a super fun drill because you get to decide when you feel like going. You're not connected to that clock. So as a student, if you want to break away and do your own 10-second pushes, go ahead. No problem. Breathe. Ready, go. Sit or stand. Me all you've got for 10. Back it off. Major power. If you've got a meter on, your watts are high right now. Your watts are the highest on those pushes. Heart rate is highest. Perceived exertion, your brain is saying, I can't do this. Your body's saying, yes, I can. Ready, go, 10 seconds, come on. Push the limit. Break through. Surprise yourself. Back it off. All right, we got a couple more minutes. Couple more opportunities to go over that edge. Red zone, breathless. Surprise yourself. Imagine a meter in front of you. Push a number higher than you've ever seen. Ready, go. Drop it back. Ow! So good. These are whippers. Woo. Butt with prayers. All right, we've got one more minute. How many do you think we can do in a minute? One, two, three. Let's see, go. Come on, go. Hardest effort. Back it off. Woo! Almost there. Recovery is next. Go. 10 seconds on. Come on. Hardest effort. Go, 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 go. Back it off. Woo! Nice job. Nice job. Ready, go. Come on. 10 seconds. Finish the song. Finish the song. Oh. 3, 2, 1. We did 3 in that last minute. That's awesome. Pedal easy. Resistance comes down. Maybe a couple minutes off. Stage 1, that was a good long stage, is behind us. Stage 2, much more enjoyable maybe. I don't know. You tell me when we're done. We've got a 5-minute hill, a 5-minute flat road, 5-minute intervals. And we're done. Climb, flat, intervals, we're done. Woo. Drink up. All right, come back in, close your eyes, breathe deep. How do you feel now? How do you feel right now? We've been going, I don't know, 40 minutes. Aches and pains, little nuances in your body. Have they shifted? Are they still there? Is it chronic? How about breath? Tension, stress, mood, emotions, thoughts. Where are you now? What's happening right now as you breathe in and breathe out? Take a deep breath in and say the word I. Hold the breath and say am, and then exhale long, happy. I am happy. I am happy. The more we say those words, the more our mind and our body believes that this is producing happiness. And we stop fighting ourselves. See, we really know that's true anyway. We know that this is a great vehicle to a happier, healthier life. It's just hard. We don't want to. We don't feel like it. So we have to switch the circuitry. We have to write new scripts in our minds. Let's add resistance to the wheel. Slow your legs, come down to about 60 RPMs. Put your hips on the very back of the saddle. And then from there, lift up. Just sit light in that saddle. We're gonna work on strength, cycling strength. I want you to feel the way you feel when you're in the weight room doing squats or lunges. The muscles in your legs doing that kind of work, squats or lunges. Every single pedal stroke is a mini lunge, a little squat, bending and straightening the knees and pushing. So more than anything else on this set, I'd like you to feel the muscles in your lower body getting stronger. So if that means for you that you need more resistance on the wheel, put it on, put it on. We are riding for happiness. We're riding for joy. Riding because it's pleasurable and it feels good. As you climb, find a little rhythm in your body. Find a little bit of rhythm. So the legs are fixed, the hips are fixed, but can you let your upper body just feel the tiniest bit of sway, ease, side to side with the shoulders, little tiny shoulder drop, maybe a little neck movement, a little bend in your elbows, a rhythm and ease. A joy. Come on. Woo. We can shift everything if we start reframing. This is not a chore. The next time you hear yourself say, I have to go work out, change that. You get to go work out. And why? Because your legs can move like this, so you get to work out. Your lungs are healthy, so you get to work out. You have equipment or a facility or safe streets to run on. You get to work out. It's a privilege so many people on this planet don't have right now for a myriad of reasons. So many people cannot do what you are doing right at this minute. You get to push yourself. You get to challenge yourself. You get the luxury of this hour for yourself. What a gift. Woo. I am happy. Add the word now. I'm happy now. Yes, life is crazy out there, but right here, right now, I can find happiness. I just need to remember help. Opportunity, time, means, abundance. It's all right here. It's all mine right now. So lucky. So lucky. Ah. All right. Did I get us up that hill? Okay, sermon number two for the day. Woo. All right, we've reached the top of that hill. We're heading into some endurance work. And endurance just means being able to do something kind of hard longer. So let's see. Easy to moderate resistance with fast legs again. You can go up as fast as 100 RPMs. If you'd like, just close your eyes. Feel the difference. This is not like doing lunges in the weight room. This is more like being on a treadmill or an elliptical or a stationary bike. Fast legs. You'll feel this more in your lungs and your heart, less in your legs. Building a different system. cardiovascular endurance, muscular endurance, the ability to do something hard longer. See if you can keep your upper body just relaxed and calm on this stretch of endurance. Wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. So you can close your eyes, put your bike in your mind on a real flat road, a true long stretch of highway. Somewhere beautiful, no traffic, no one to interrupt you, just you on the road. And out there, what makes you happy? So hopefully now the answer can be something a little closer to home. What makes me happy? Good cycling shoes. Being in no pain makes me happy. Strong muscles that respond when the resistance gets on. A heart beating in my chest, getting stronger by the minute. Makes you happy? Sweat. Being able to keep up with your children or your grandchildren. Hiking because you've done this. You've built a body that can hike or swim or ski. What makes you happy? Bring it close to home. In this moment, what is making you happy? Feel that sweat. Endurance does that. When we start hitting endurance, it seems like the sweat spigots get turned on. Like the body kind of knows what to predict and it just cools, cools. We've got about a minute. My friends, here's what makes me happy. I mean, I know it's the last song, and I can just take off the lid, empty my pockets, spend all that spare change, charge up the credit card, and finish it. That's what we're gonna do right now. 5 minute song, speed plus strength. We put both together. So we'll be back on that strong resistance. And then I will ask you to do this against that resistance. And we'll just use that idea of gratitude to get us through this last song. Gratitude. And we'll start from the ground and work up. So our first sprint, gratitude for our feet. So I want you to feel your feet on the pedals, wiggle your toes inside of your shoes. Resistance turns up, our legs slow down. We're at about 60 RPMs. We did 10 second pushes before. Now we're gonna do 20. We'll stand up. We'll sprint for 20 seconds. will recover for 40. Okay? Double. I'm going to give you back double. Let's put a little bit of gear on that wheel. Find that strength. We're back in the weight room. 3, 2, 1. Let's get the first one. Stand up. Sprint for power. Sprint to breathless. Hard as you can work against that gear. Come on. 20's longer than 10, but we got this. 3, 2, 1. Come back to your saddle. Keep that slow, steady gear going. Woo. You got this. Twenty on, 40 off. Core engaged, stay tall. All right, get ready, friends. 20 second sprint with resistance. Out of the saddle, let's go. Come on, energy. You're happy. You love this. Woo. Come on, keep it going, keep it going. 3, 2, and come on back to your saddle. Woo. We're gonna do that 2 more times, and that's it. We're headed to cool down. 2 more 20 second pushes. I know you've got what it takes. Really top of the mountain right here, friends. Put your hips back. Woo. Let those feet push forward more than down. Here it comes. 20 seconds. Out of the saddle. Resistance on. Up and here we go. Woo. Come on, feel that. Feel that amazing strength you have. There it is. Right there for the taking. 3, 2, 1. Bring it down. Try to stay on your heel. Don't do what I just did and drop that gear. Get it back on, Denise. One more. One more. Woo. Happy. This is our last song. Happy. Because we did it. Feeling better. Last push. Distance is on. Ready, set, let's get it. Let's get it. Let's get happy. Woo. Come on. Woo. 3, 2, come back to your heel. Try not to touch that resistance. Let's ride to the top, and then we'll cool it down. Oh, that feels good. That feels good. And yes, those 3 words, I did it, are powerful words. There's the top right there. Top of the hill right in front of us. End of stage 2. See, told you it was shorter. Nice. That's it. Wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. Say out loud, I did it, and I am happy. Down with the resistance, up with your torso. All right, swing your arms up and back. Exhale and just throw them up, up, up this time, and then open. Let's do kind of like a snow angel, little bent elbow thing. Reach your arms out, thumbs back, palms up. Stop your legs and just rotate to one side and back and switch. Do that again, just repeat to each side. Just twist and twist and release. Shake your hands. Bend your elbows, shake them out, shoulders roll. And let's stretch it out. Come on up to your feet, press your heels down. That'll wake up your calves, and then just scoot your hips back. Find a hamstring stretch. You can just bend and straighten a couple times. See if you can find that front hamstring with the calves. Ah. Beautiful job. Walking away from this ride happier and healthier. Only because we were reminded that it's already here. We just have to come home. It's all right here. It's not out there. As we release our hips, let's come off the bike and onto the floor. And take your feet nice and wide and just shift your hips to one side. Feel that stretch around the TFL muscle and then come up and switch to the other side. Do that a few times. Just give your side body a little release. And then let's come into the hip flexors. Take one foot behind, just tuck the tailbone. Lift your rib cage up. Same arm comes up and back. If you'd prefer, you can grab your foot in your hand. I really like this one sometimes for a change. Lengthen and lift. So of course, once we find that inner spring of happiness that's always here, switch sides, we become a joyful person that attracts joyful people. And we get to spend our time in circles of more happiness and more joy, and it just multiplies. Bring your arms behind, open up your chest. So be that person, that happiness magnet. You've already done the hard work of showing up. And if you can just step off your bike and just live in this space of I'm happy now, watch. Just watch what happens around you. Make the world a brighter place. Thank you so much for riding with me today. Put your hands together in front of your heart, a gesture of gratitude, and also just a big hand for yourself. You did it. Happy now. Have a great day.